iOS 16.1 RC is out, my friends. So if you are on a better version, you can install it on your device. So the final version should be released next week on October 24. And as you can see, it's a large file on my iPhone 14 Pro Max. It's 5.26 gigabyte, very large file to install. But it's only available for developers. So if you are on the beta version, you can go ahead and install it. And for public, it's gonna come out next week on October 24. So let's go ahead and check out the features. Stay tuned. Okay guys, now that my phone finished install the iOS 16.1 RC, so I'm gonna go and open it up and I'm gonna show you the build number. So we're gonna go to about, and from that we can find the build number and setting and then about. So let's go to about and then let's go to iOS 16. Let's click in here and this is the build number and this is the iOS 16 20B79. So this update includes improvements and bug fixes for your iPhone. So this is gonna be the final number of the final version of the software. And this is the developer version. So the RC is for developers, but it's gonna be available for general public next week. So next week, that's where they're gonna launch the final version of the iOS 16.1 for iOS devices, such as iPhone, Apple Watch, and also Mac OS and iPad, and also Apple TV. And in this version of the iOS 16.1, there will be Apple Finance, where you can open up a saving account. I don't want to talk about it too much because I don't know how it works, but apparently there's gonna be a saving account where you can open up your own saving account and save up money. So we'll find out how it works next week when we get into more details about the Apple Finance. There's also live activity where you can track your like activity. For example, Uber Eats is supporting live activity. Let's go check it out. Hold on, let me go download Uber Eats and see what happens. Actually, you have to order something to see live activity. So we're gonna come back to that next time. And also today, guys, I found the Google widget on the lock screen, for example. So let's go open it up. You see here, you get Google widget. You get Google Plus and also the Chrome widget and the Gmail. So those are new on this version of the iOS 16.1. For example, when I open up to my lock screen, I can tap in here and then you get Google open up where you can talk and ask questions. For example, where can I find a coffee shop? And then it should come up. You know, this is very rare that Apple allow Google to do that, to put a widget where you can tap and just ask questions. So this is what I got. You know, I was just showing you the widget, how it works. And also when I close it and I go to tap on the Chrome widget, it comes up as well. And over here you can ask a question. And this is what I got. It opened up. I was just talking, but you know, it's not like a real question I was asking. And also guys, the battery percentage was showing only on the iPhone 14, but now with the new version iOS 16.1, the battery percentage will show into the battery for all the devices. So if you have an iPhone 13, iPhone 12 and iPhone 10, you'll be able to see the battery percentage like this in here into the percentage into the battery instead of on the side. There is also a shared library, like photo shared library, in this version of the iOS 16.1. For example, let's go to settings and then you tap on your name here on top of the and then you go to iCloud and you go to photos. So when you go scroll down, you're gonna see there's an option here, shared library. So you can set it up and share your photos, your library with some other people, your family, for example, you know, any picture you take, it can show on your family iPhone. So it says share photo and videos from moments spent together with family and close friends on one library. All right, I think that's a great option right here. It's a really, really great feature. So going back to photo library, so I'm gonna go back so I can show you more options. So here I'm gonna select set up share library, and I'm gonna say get started. And what should I do? Add recipient. You can add people that you want, but for now let me just go I say add later. Let's leave it like that. And I want to go back to and more photos later and invite later. All right, so I turned it on, and now when you go to the camera, and then you're gonna see those little people in here, for example. So from here, this you can enable it or disable it. As you can see it here, nice and clear. You can turn it off or turn it on. When you turn it on, any photo you take is gonna be shared directly with your friends or family, whoever you wanna share your library with. So we're gonna disable it for now. And then also when you go to photos here, and when you go to all photos on those three dots right here, you can also personalize your library. You can share library, you can check it out, or you can uncheck it if you don't want to share it with nobody. So I think it's a great feature. It's very nice on this version of the iOS 16.1. And there is a Fitness Plus option. Even if you don't have an Apple Watch, you can still use the Fitness Plus capability. And all you have to do is open up your fitness app and select one of those activities you wanna do. So guys, that's all I have for now about this new software, iOS 16.1. So, I'm gonna play with it for a few days and then I'll come back. But the final version should come out next week on October 24 for all iOS devices. But I think it's a great update. So I don't know how the battery life is gonna be, but that's something that I'm gonna come back to that in next few days. So I'm gonna see how this thing behaves and how it works. And then from that, I can give you more my thought about this new version. Okay guys, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so that you can get notified every time I upload a new video on YouTube. Thank you for watching.